Hello friends, today we'll see the solar PV module part 1, which is coming under the module solar energy and the solar thermal application. In this one we'll discuss about IV and PV characteristics and what are the things which will affect the IV and PV characteristics and what will be the parameters of the solar cell. So let's begin with the presentation. Condense for this, what is STC, what is PV and IV characteristics, what is the effect of the radiance, what is the effect of temperature on the solar IV and PV characteristics. The last one is the parameters of the solar cell. So let's begin with what is STC. See, STC is a standard test condition which is refers to the following condition. Actually, why we require this term? Because all the solar panel and whatever things parameters are given at the condition of STC. So some means anything which is manufactured in electrical terms, it should be have a some test condition. But here for the PV, it is clearly mentioned that it is whatever the parameters or whatever things are mentioned at the STC only. So if you are having any panel and you are reading the configurations, so definitely it is mentioned at the STC condition only. So STC condition means what? It having that during STC is tested, means whatever panel is there, it should be testing at the STC condition. So STC condition condensed means what? It is 1000 watt per meter square solar radiation. The solar radiation amount is what? 1000 watt per meter square, and at that time the temperature of the cell will be 25 degree Celsius, and air mass, the spectrum of air mass is required is 1.5. actually it is the value. What is a spectrum means? It is an angle. The spectrum, what is given, the cosine, inverse of the cos and cos theta. Okay, air mass is equal to 1 by cos theta. That cos theta, the theta is the angle between the zenith and the solar panel. So means this is the angle. Okay, so that is usually taken as a 1.5. and the one which is not mentioned in STC, but we know that wind speed should be 1 meter per second. Okay, so these are the STC condition on which any panel the rating is given actually. So STC is usually will mention in a solar PV module. So in STC condition, usually it is always to be remembered that it should be 1000 watt per meter square and the temperature is 25 degree Celsius. As mass, okay, we required, but these two parameters is most important. Air mass, what we are getting on the surface, what it is 1.5 only. So that is mentioned, means the parameter that only it is written, the value of a solar cell parameter is given by the manufacturer at STC conditions only. So this is the IV and PV characteristics. See, both is plotted in the same graph, IV and PV. But IV graph first we see in the left side cell current in ampere, and in x-axis we have a cell voltage in PV. So cell voltage in the volts. So we'll see the graph which is started with ISC, okay, and then straight and then going to end and at VOC. So this is the IV characteristics. So when ISC is there, means short circuit current is there, then that time voltage is zero. When you are getting the VOC, then current is zero. Okay, so when ISC is there, voltage is zero. When voltage is there, open circuit voltage is there, then current is zero. Okay, now if you see the PV characteristics, so in the right side, the cell power in watt and cell voltage in x-axis, again the same axis only taken, and the graph is plotted. Yes, so when you're multiplying, P is what? In a DC current, the power is equal to V into I. Okay, because whatever we are getting the output in a solar PV system is a DC. So DC power is given by voltage into current, a simple equation. So in a starting case, current is very high, but voltage is very zero. So what happens? The power is equal to zero. Then as the current is there, voltage started increasing. So it started linearly increasing. You can see in from this graph. Okay. Then at some point, that P point, what happens? The current and the voltage is high. So that point you are getting as MPP, PMPP. It is the point, actually. We can say this is the point of the maximum power. Means what is the maximum power you can obtain from the PV cell, that is given by this point actually. At this point, if your PV is operating, definitely you will get the maximum power. Then slightly as the ISC is reducing, so what happens? Definitely your graph also started reducing. At VOC, what happens? The current ISC is zero and VOC is very high. But power is a multiplication of current into voltage. So definitely power is equal to zero. So this is the graph regarding the IV and PV characteristics. Okay. And we have seen in this graph, we have getting so many parameters. So in this graph, it is mentioned what is ISC. At maximum power point, means the P, when you are getting the maximum power, when the current is maximum, current is there, and the voltage is there, definitely multiplication of it, you will get the maximum power. So at that point, what is the current and what is the voltage? That is given by current is given by IMPP, and voltage is given by VMPP. And this whole graph is mentioned at the STC condition. If it is given by the manufacturer, then it is given at the STC condition. Means at 1000 watt per meter square. Means at 1 meter area, what radiation is coming is 1000. That is taken. And the temperature of the cell is taken as the surrounding temperature is taken as a 25 degree. This is the ideal case actually. So on that time, IV and PV characteristic graph is like this. Okay. So now we see two things, because we are focusing that STC is 1000 watt per meter square and 25 degrees Celsius. So if these two things are varied, what will happen to the IV characteristics? So that we want to see, and PV characteristics. So first we will see that at 25 degree Celsius only we are keeping as a constant, but we'll change the radiance. That is 1000 watt per meter square, we are changing it. We are reducing it. Okay. So because we know during a morning time at 6 o'clock in the morning, we have a very less radiation, you know, less than 100 watt. But same time when it is at noon 12, what happens is it will be more than 1000 watt per meter square. Again in the evening, again it is reduced. So there will be a you will get a one big curve in that one. Okay. So that curve, so definitely the radiation what we are getting from the sun is not a constant. So definitely vary. So we can't maintain the radiation. So that variation, according to that one, what will be effect on the IV curve, that is shown here. So pink line shows you the radiation curve. Means IV characteristics at 1000 watt per meter square. Okay, when it is 800 watt per meter square, then it is a blue line. See, IC is reduced. IC is reduced. Means short circuit current is reduced. Okay, previously it is near to 2, now it is 1.5. But VOC is remains same. At X axis, what is voltage? So it is remains same. Again, when it is 600 watt per meter square, green line. See, again it is reduced. ISC is reduced, but VOC is nearly equal to same VOC what we have getting in 1000. Same way at 400, again the ISC is reduced. Okay, again in a 200 black line you can see ISC is reduced. So effect is what happening, that in a IV characteristics, according to the radiation, okay, is reducing. What is happening? The ISC, short circuit current, is reduced. VOC having very little impact. But because ISC is changing, definitely the output power, P, also change, which will affect in a maximum power point and the PV characteristics also. That we'll see now. So this will be a graph of the PV at the same at 25 degrees Celsius and variance with the according to the radiance. So you can see previously the power point of pink line is very high, the power, maximum power is very high, but again this curve, whole curve is reduced. Okay, so knee is reducing, actually you can see it is a knee where the maximum power is occurring. So knee of the miss where the maximum point is there, or maximum power you can obtain, is reduced. So it is reduced and reduced, and when it is 2000, it is so much reduced. So much reduced, actually, from the 1000 watt to the 200 watt per meter square. So in the effect of the radiance means the what happens, that as the ISC is reduced in IV curve, here the maximum power, whatever we are obtaining in the PV curve or the from the solar panel, is reduced. That is the effect of the radiance because of the in the PV curve. So now we see the temperature effect, but keeping the radiance, that solar radiation insulation as 1000 watt per meter square. So PV's performance again declines here. So here, as the temperature is increasing, so it is a zero degree Celsius. You can see the black line, 25. See, ISC is remains same, but VOC is changing. This is the IV characteristics. So VOC is changing. So what is the effect because of the temperature? VOC is changing, by ISC remains same. So as the temperature is increasing, ideally we are taken as a 25 degrees Celsius for the panel. Okay, but as it is increasing near to the 100, what happens? It will be reduced. Okay, so VOC is reduced. So it will impact your maximum power again. So again, your maximum power is reduced in PV characteristics. So in a PV characteristics, you can see the power reduced because of the temperature, but radiance will be the same. So this power point, that this knee is started reducing, and this is the final at 100 degrees Celsius, very small graph of the PV. Okay, so this is the effect of the temperature and the radiance on the PV and IV characteristics. Next one, we list the parameters of the solar cell that affects the conversion. So first one is the short circuit current, ISC, open circuit voltage, VOC, maximum power point, current at the maximum power point, IM, voltage at the maximum power point, VM, fill factor, FF, efficiency, okay, eta. So this is the graph we have taken for the reference again, that is the IV graph. Okay, in this one it is mentioned what is ISC, what is IM, what is VM and VOC. So we'll see the definition of all this. Short circuit current, ISC. Okay, this is the maximum current a solar cell can produce. Okay, so you can see it's a maximum current what the solar cell is producing of, that is ISC. Okay, and it is measured in ampere and milliampere. If ISC is higher, definitely cell is a better one. Okay, so but what it depends upon, It is depends upon the cell technology, angle of the cell and cell area, and amount of the solar radiation. Yes, solar radiation we have seen. ISE, as it is reducing, definitely ISE is reduced. Okay. So another form, if it is the current density is given, JSE is given, then definitely we can able to find ISE by the formula. Density means always be related to area, then ISE divided by area. Area is the area of the cell. Okay, that is about the ISE. Next one is the open circuit voltage, VOC. Okay, in accesses you can see the maximum voltage, that is VOC. So maximum voltage that is produced by the solar cell is known as a VOC. A simple definition, it is measured, definitely voltage, it is measured in a voltage or the mini volt. Okay, if the VOC is very higher, definitely the cell is better. We know if VOC is higher, definitely your output will be higher. So it, what it depends upon? It depends upon the cell technology and operating temperature. Next one, maximum power point. Yes, we have seen previously also what is the maximum power point. See, at maximum power, it's a maximum power that solar cell can produce under the STC condition. Under the STC condition, standard test condition, what is the maximum power is generated? Means 1000 watt per meter square and 25 degree Celsius. At this condition, what is the maximum power produced by that solar cell is known as a, and at which point it is produced is known as a point, maximum power point, and what power is produced is a maximum power. Okay, so higher the PM, definitely better the cell. It is measured in the watts. Okay, definitely power. So it is definitely measured in the watts only. So usually in a manufacturer, they will write this maximum power as a WP or V peak. Okay, sometimes will not written a PM or PMAX. It will be write as a WP or WP peak. Usually WP P because it's very easy notation. At this point, what is the current and the voltage? Okay, corresponding to X and Y axis. If it is on the Y axis means current. So that current is known as IM and voltage is VM. So maximum power occurs at the knee or the bend of the IV curve. Definitely we know it's a bend here. So at this bend, the maximum power occurs. So PM is equal to VM into IM. So that is a simple equation because it's a DC power output. So we know the DC power is equal to V into I. So here PM is equal to definitely VM into whatever the corresponding voltage and whatever corresponding current is there. So now what is the definition for the current at the maximum power point? IM. So this is the current at which the solar cell will produce when the operating at the maximum power point. Okay. And yeah, but we have seen from the graph that always be ISE is greater than IM and VOC will be greater than VM. Okay, that is mentioned here. That only is mentioned here. That IM will always be lesser than VOC. And it is mentioned in ampere and milliampere. Same way, what we already told, VM is always be lesser than VOC. And it is measured in the volts and the mini volt. Yes, second last one, fill factor. It's a ratio of the area covered by IM VM rectangle to the area covered by ISE and VSE triangle rectangle. So whatever area it is covered, VM and IM, is definitely less compared to ISE into ISE and VSE. So it is given always in a percentage. So FF is equal to IM into VM. Okay, because rectangle we know area means length into breadth. So IM into VM, and next area is covered is ISE into VOC. But IM into VM we know what is the, it is a maximum power. So that is given by PM. And so PM divided by ISE into VOC. So PM equation also we can find from this way. That is ISC into VOC into fill factor. You see the fill factor for the ideal solar cell we have taken as a 1, but this should be never be 1. Okay, this always be 0.86 something around because of the internal resistance. So ISC is never equal to IM. Actually, for that reason it is always be less. Next one is efficiency. So efficiency of the solar cell is defined as the maximum power output divided by the input power PN. So eta will be always be eta, or it is given also in a percentage only. So eta is equal to PM divided by PN. So PM is equal to ISC VOC into fill factor divided by the PN, that is the power input, and area, because area is taken, so it will be more efficient. So this is the equation for the efficiency, because always be efficiency equation is always be output by input. Okay, we are taking efficiency. So efficiency of the solar cell we have already talked about. Okay, so that's all about today's presentation. Thank you.